Well, this is Daniel Towsey. It is now February 2018, and I'm in BC, in British Columbia. And for those of you who have followed all my reports that I've done over the years, and all the reporting that I've done about the evils in this world and many other things, I've been at this for like 40 years. And there's been a lot of things that have been very, very serious, and I've had some pretty serious attempts on my life. I'm going to provide some links below this video to some of my other reports, but I'm going to try to give you some information here about a very important thing that occurred again to me. And I'll do my best. I have a few photos that you can see that'll help you to understand what I'm about to tell you. And just check the link below this video. So I'll assume that you, I have some followers that have been following my reports about the attempts on my life and other things that have occurred. So after I left Montreal back in June of 2017, near the beginning of June, I made it all the way to Sault.Saint.Marie, but I didn't have enough cash to make it all the way back to British Columbia. So I spent about 2.5 weeks in Sault.Saint.Marie in Ontario, waiting for my money to be deposited in my bank account so I could drive the rest of the way back to British Columbia. Now, in Sault.Saint.Marie, I got this idea that, shit, you know, here I am running all these websites and reporting all this stuff that's going on. And I had learned a lot more about this Islamic thing that Trudeau is doing to this country. So I had written a few things on my car. And I'll try to provide the link. I will provide the link below this video that you can see what I've done to my car and other people have done and all this writing. My car is basically a mobile social media platform now. It's got writing all over it and big bold letters and all kinds of important messages about my different websites and what's going on in the world. So I was parked at the Walmart over in Sault.Saint.Marie, and I did a test and I wrote something on my car. And Sault.Saint.Marie is a very, very depressing place. It's a very, very anti-social place. There's no people walking on the sidewalks. There's no life there. It's kind of a spooky kind of place. So I'm parked in the Walmart parking lot, and all of a sudden I'm noticing I'm getting a reaction from people, a lot of people, especially women. And they're reading what's written on my car, and they're all smiling. It's like the first time in their life they've ever seen anybody like me around, or anybody that's, you know, talking by writing things on his car and doing what I'm doing. So amongst a lot of people, like it's usual for me, I became somewhat of a social celebrity in that town. But I got targeted. And I was harassed so that I couldn't eat at the soup kitchen and other things anyway. I had to try to find a place to park at nighttime, where I wouldn't be bothered by anybody and I wouldn't be bothered by the police. I didn't want to do a whole lot of driving because I didn't have much gas in my car. So I was parking my for a few nights there. I parked at the end of the parking lot at the casino in Sault.Saint.Marie. And as you know, all the casinos in Canada are all owned by the government. The corporate government, the criminal government, because we don't have any governments. So this one night, after I'd been parking basically in the same spot, I learned long ago that if I do the same thing and I'm always predictable, the people that target me can make plans to come after me and do me harm. And they often have the police helping them, like happened on this evening. But police are like military, they kind of follow orders and do what they're told. So what I'm about to try to tell you is quite unbelievable, and it's I waited quite a few months to do this report that I'm doing right now, because it took me a while to figure out how I'm going to present this to you. So on this night where I was parked, it's a very dark place. Very dark place. There's very few lights. There's a few lights in the parking lot where I was at. But I was in the end of the parking lot, and beside me, to my right of my car, there's a property there for tourist information. So all of a sudden, this is like 1 o'clock in the morning, 2 o'clock in the morning, there's practically no one anywhere, there's nobody on the streets. Behind me, to my right, I hear a really, really loud crash from a vehicle. So the vehicle was approaching me at a very high speed from my right, coming up a street there that was basically lined up straight with where I was parked, because there was a slight little curve in the road there. So there was a vehicle coming at a well over 100 miles an hour, maybe 130 miles an hour. It was really moving fast. And it was coming right at my car, right at me. And there was a slight little curve there where the intersection was, where there's the satellites. So where the curve went to the, if the person's facing my car and they're on my right and they're coming towards me, the road curved a little bit to the left. So I'm parked right there where the road is curving. So this car, this vehicle was coming at a full speed. I hear this loud crash, so right away, the vehicle hadn't even stopped moving and I was already calling 911. And it's a small town and 911 answered very quickly, and they already knew why I was calling before I even told them. Which I always thought was really strange, because I was the only person reporting this. I was right there. I mean, I called them like within seconds of the vehicle coming to a stop. And I was really wondering how the hell they would know what I was talking about and where I was at. So I get out of my car and I go look, and I bring my camera with me and I go look at what's going on. Look at the photos and you'll see that what had happened, this vehicle came down this road, and just as the road is turning to the left for the driver that's coming towards me, the vehicle kept going straight where I was parked. It was aiming right at my car. So it went off the road onto the sidewalk, and there's some aluminum posts there for streetlights. They break really easy, okay? You're going really fast, your car will just fly right through those things. But what had happened here is that there was a steel post there with the traffic lights on it. But it wasn't a full height post, it was just a short one, but it was a really thick old one. And this minivan hit this post, and the minivan didn't quite snap it off, it bent it. And the minivan went up on the post, and the post was bending downwards, so the minivan went up and flew up in the air, because it flew right off the steel post, and the post was bending down. And the minivan kept going, landed on the sidewalk, went back on the road, and went across the road and through a fence into a schoolyard. And where the minivan came to rest, to stop, was actually like a few feet behind my car on the other side of the road. So I'm right there. When I get out of my car to go see what had just happened, the road that was behind my car, which is a three-lane road, it's a one-way road. There was two police cars that were parked on that road, just to slightly to the right of where the van came to stop. And the two police cars were diagonal like this. And they were blocking the road, but they didn't have any lights on, not even driving lights. They had no lights on. And that's when I stepped out of my car. They were already there. And I had been on the phone for like 20 seconds. And the accident just happened. So the police cars were already there before the accident happened, with no lights on. Up the street, when I walked up there, I noticed that the fire truck and other emergency vehicles were already on both sides of... Because where that street, the set of lights is, was an intersection, right? So it's a T. You know, it's a T. So here's the road that the vehicle is on. And right here is the intersection. And on this side, this road going this way, there was already vehicles that were sitting there. Emergency vehicles. And all of them had no lights on. So they were already all there before the accident happened. So right away I knew, well, this was all set up. They tried to kill me. They tried to run a car into me at full speed, a van. when I walked over to the van and when I came out of my car, there was no ambulance there. There was no driver in the van. It was remote control. As you see the photos, you see all the airbags, you'll notice that the minivan's doors are not open. The driver's door is not open. There was no driver. I am not kidding you. And for all of you that pay attention to remote control, I did a report a while ago about remote control vehicular assassinations. I never thought of the idea that they could use the vehicle to like run you over with it without even having a driver in the vehicle. Well, that's a new one. I didn't think of that one before, but it happened to me. And I kept walking around and I talked to people, and there's always operatives there, you know, like handlers, I guess you would call them. So when I was walking around, all the police that from that town and the fire department, they're just going along with what they're told to do. But there's always somebody in charge that's above them that comes from somewhere else. You know, the people that are professional at targeting people, like CSIS and other organizations. CSIS is like the CIA, because I'm in Canada. So I'm walking all around and I'm taking photos and I'm looking and realizing what had just happened. This minivan drove literally at full speed. Like, we're talking about really, really fast. I don't know how fast that thing can go, but it had to have been doing at least 120 miles an hour. When it hit that steel post, which wasn't anticipated by these idiots that planned all this out, they didn't quite realize where I was parked, there was a steel post there. So that blew their plan of hitting my vehicle. This minivan would have just torn the roof right off my car. Like, they would have flown up where I was at, where I was parked, they would have just literally ran right into me. Now, I walked all around and I looked and I took pictures and I realized that there was no driver, there was no ambulance, this was all pre-set up. And I do know that most cops are good people. But we live in a system where we have a shadow government running everything behind the scenes, and they're a bunch of criminals. And people have to start realizing what's going on in our society. We've got to take our governments back like Donald Trump is doing. But in Canada, we have a different problem. We don't have a swamp, we have a cesspool. In our house, which is called the House of Commons in Ottawa, well, the cesspool hasn't been drained of its shit for a long, long time. And that's been my mission for many, many years, to try to bring attention to the people, what we have to do in Canada. Anyway. Now, after I walked around for a while in the dark there and realized, I looked all around and realized, like, this is pretty scary. I mean, I'm thinking, holy shit, like, these people are serious and they've never ever left me alone. I've had so many attempts on my life and so many serious things happen. God's been looking out for me for a reason. After I stopped walking around and taking pictures and analyzing the whole situation and looking at the distance to the van, I walked the street there at nighttime and I understand the whole thing now. You ready for this one now? It's very dark where I'm at. There's just a few lights up high, you know, like in a parking lot, like at Walmart. But it's late at night, it's not super bright. I go back to my car and I'm sitting in my car. The motor's not running, my lights aren't on, I'm just sitting, I'm not moving. And I look out in front of my car, and like this is dark and spooky, this place. There's no people living around that area, okay? It's more commercial than anything else. There's no houses or apartment buildings or anything where I was at. I see these two creatures. I'm going to try to describe to you what I was looking at. They would kind of look like dogs. You would think they were dogs. But they're not any dogs that I've ever seen in my life or in magazines or anything else. They were very, very short haired. They were both dark. Very dark, almost, you know, black. They were very sleek, very, very, very firm. Like, these were like athletes as far as dogs are concerned. And they worked as a team. There was two of them. And I'll just say it the way it is. To me, it looked like these were trained machines for killing. These were not ordinary dogs. These were really dangerous, dangerous animals. And they're not. They had to be genetically created or something, because they were not normal dogs, not at all. They come towards the front of my car, and they're looking around. They never looked in the car. They never saw me because I didn't move. But I'm watching them. And they look like they're looking for, they have a scent, and they're looking for me. They're looking for, because they went to my car door. And they were sniffing at the ground beside, and they followed my path where I had walked. Because when I left my car, I know which way I walked. And the dogs were looking for me. They were looking for me because they had my scent. And at this time, there was no police outside. They were sitting in their car. There was nobody that would be in any danger from these dogs, because everyone else was told to not be there. There was no one else there. And these dogs didn't find me because I didn't get out of my car after that. But these are not dogs. These are, I wish I could figure out how to describe to you how scary these things look. They were. They looked like they were Satan's satanic dogs. I mean, like you would think you would see this in a fiction movie, a fabrication from somebody somehow, because these things were not normal animals at all. So I realized what I was looking at. I was looking at a professional attempt to hit on my life, and the dogs were their second, I guess, what do they call it? When the first plan fails, it was a second plan, and I failed too. The next night that I parked, I didn't park there anymore. I went up just on the edge of town, and there's a lot of fields that haven't been developed yet. Anyway, I'm parked in a kind of a muddy field. And again, at 2 o'clock in the morning, around that time, a police car pulled, because I'm like kind of like in a farmer's field. It's kind of rough. A police car pulls up and parks beside my car window. He's facing the rear of my car, and he's parked right beside me. He's talking to me. Now, he's a good cop. He came there to protect me. A lot of good cops have done that. A lot of good cops know I'm being targeted, and it doesn't take them very long to know why, because you just go on the internet and you quickly find out what I've been reporting. Like the fact that I was an eyewitness to how they've been rigging our elections in Canada. If you go to CanadianSituations.wordpress.com, you'll see a lot of my reports. And if you go to TrueSoldier.com, you'll see more. If you go to DanielTauzy.wordpress.com, you'll see more. I have a lot of websites, and I have a lot of really amazing, powerful stuff that I've been publishing. And it's not just my work on my websites. It's a lot of other people's work, too, that are trying to wake you up and help this world. So when this police officer pulled in to talk to me, he knew that there was an attempted hit on me. He was curious. He wanted to know what I was about. You know, he wasn't there to cause me any trouble, and he wasn't a bad guy. And I met lots of good police officers. I met a lot of good people in my life. So he talked to me. But as he's talking to me, two other police cars come flying in, and they pull up in front of me. Don't forget, really where I am right now, I'm in the middle of nowhere. There's no houses, there's no cars, there's no people, there's nothing there. They could shoot me, nobody would ever know. So the good cop basically saved my life, because he knew there was still going to be another attempt on me with uniformed officers. So the other two guys in the other police cars were younger guys, young and stupid. And they didn't talk to me. They just sat there for a couple of hours, and they left. But the other officer basically stayed beside my car for most of the night to make sure that I survived the night. Actually, that was the night that they tried to kill me with that minivan. That's what it was, the same night. And I haven't done any reports like this about my situation in a while. I'm going through a lot of horrible things. My life is not any better. I'm not getting any help from anyone. I'm not getting any PayPal donations on my websites like I used to get. I don't have enough money to live. I'm not driving my car. Luckily, I have a roof over my head. It's just temporary. I don't want to talk about my situation, because it only helps the bad guys to screw me over more. All I can ask you to do is pray to God for me, because, and for us, and for this planet. Because what Trudeau's doing with Canada and Islam is really bad, and the women are going to suffer. And remember that Trudeau is connected with the Clinton Foundation and the Queen. There's so much stuff going on in the world, it's so complicated. But God sent us an angel. A lot of angels. There's a lot of good people in the world now that are working to bring down this worldwide empire of insanity that's killing the planet. The Satanists, child molesters. I've been reporting on this stuff for 20 years on the internet. I really do know what's going on. I'm still being denied medical services, a doctor. I'm being denied all disability benefits. I don't even have my pension that I'm supposed to have. I do not have enough money to live off of. And every day is stressful because my living situation is not good. I've been robbed, I've been assaulted by people, I've been denied food banks. Every time I go to a soup kitchen, I get harassed by the staff. And I discovered that across the country, all the soup kitchens that you have are all covers. And the people that live upstairs, that are paid to live there, are all sleeper cells, Manchurian candidates. The missions, I guess what they're called, the missions. Be careful with the missions because they're not what you think they are. The people that are actually living there and they're being well fed, they're being clothed, they're given everything they need, they're not homeless people. You see the homeless that go in to have a meal there, but they get crappy food. The people that live in the missions upstairs are not homeless people. They're all operatives for the system. That's what the missions are for. And I've seen them across the country, so I know it's the same thing they're doing. They use the missions for their cover for their agents, whoever they may be, or whatever they're going to use them for. And I'm not kidding you. This is really happening. I've had other things happen to me, like my trailer was sabotaged, my wheelchair trailer. I'll provide the links below this video so you can see what's been going on, and that's just a little bit of what's been going on. When I arrived here at the end of June, I went to Guilt Camp, which is a 4x4 lawless place, and I was being terrorized there by the same shadow government agents. And boy, they have no shortage of criminals that can send after you to harm you and to terrorize you. At that camp, I had a guy shooting a gun, threatening to kill me. There's so much stuff that's been going on. If I was to do videos like this one here of all the events, because I do photography and I do videos, I have the evidence, I have photos, I have proof. I just want everybody to know that all the stuff that I've done all my life for the good of humanity has never been for me. If it had been, I'd be a selfish person, I'd be very wealthy, and I wouldn't give a fuck about the planet or about you or about anything. That's just not me. It's just not me, and it never will be. Right now, I'm praying that everyone wakes up in this world and realizes the danger that we're in. And the only reason why we're all in danger is because you're too stupid to pay attention to people like me, and you're not telling anybody else, you're not doing any research, and you're not waking up, and you're not realizing that if the good people don't do good, then the bad people are going to take control of everything, and the bad people are going to kill the good people. And, you know, the population thing with the Georgia Guidestones, you have to realize that the world is run by the insane. And the insane are people who avoid truth. Anyway, I don't want to repeat stuff that I've said many times before. My name is Daniel Jew Joseph Towsey. I'm known as a true soldier. And the battle continues for the planet to survive. All the weather patterns in the planet are screwed up. All these forest fires are all man-made. The chemtrailing is killing the planet. The Fukushima is out of control. It hasn't stopped. Yeah, well, at least BC has a little bit more wildlife than anywhere else in Canada. I did a lot of tree reports about all the trees dying everywhere. There's the same problem here, but it's not as serious because I'm in between mountains here. I'm in a valley of the Rocky Mountains, so it's a little bit healthier. The Canadian people are homeless all over the country. This country is being taken over. You need to go on the internet and find out what's happening to all the Christian people of the world, and all the white people, all the Jewish people, for that matter, anybody that's not Islamic is under attack by Islam. Islam is doing a caliphate. It's in their Quran. They are the New World Order. They want to run the planet. You better learn that who created Islam. Go do some research. I can't confirm this, but the evidence of what I've been researching is it was created by the Catholic Church. And the evidence that the Catholic Church is part of the Roman Empire is full of Satanists and other evil. And they do have a black pope. Anyway, I don't want to do a bunch of history lessons here. And this video has been going on for 26 minutes. So, right now, I am not really able to drive my car anymore because the government's refusing to give me insurance or let me buy insurance because they're refusing to give me license plates on my car. The Quebec government tried to take my driver's license from me and put it in the system that they had suspended my license. Luckily, the BC government let me have my license because I exchanged my license because I told them why Quebec did it. Because Quebec, if you saw the report I did before when I left Quebec, Quebec gave me $850 worth of parking tickets, so I left the province. So, anyway, I don't want to make this video really, really long. There's just so much going on. I appreciate you watching this. You better start caring about what's right and what's wrong. And you better start caring about all the women, our women. Because Trudeau's just passed a law allowing women to be sexually mutilated when they're 6 years old. He's passing every law you can imagine to make Canada an Islamic state, and Sharia law. He's putting that above all our laws. He's doing that. He said he's going to bring in another million immigrants. And these immigrants are bringing in are barbarians. They're Islamic barbarians, and they are fighting age men. We are in a war. And they are clever. The way they operate is like the Trojan horse. All those people, that when the Trojan horse and the soldiers came out and all those people died, you think they even knew they were going to die? Think they even knew? No. That's how Islam operates. But now today, we have something. We have the World Wide Web. We have people like me on the internet trying to wake you up and get you to realize we've got a problem. So it's time to care about something besides yourself. That I'm hoping you care about yourself. But you have to care more than that. This worldwide insanity's got to be stopped. And the only way we're going to defeat this evil is to expose it to the light of truth. And how you do that is you speak about the evil they do. So that you can wake up other people so we can stop the evil. And I'm not a conspiracy theorist, okay, and neither are you. Because there's no theory about the conspiracies. They're real. So, what am I? I'm a true soldier. And remember, I was saying that truthers always sound insane. when they're telling what the insane are doing. I've been doing my best for a very, very long time. You know, on the internet, Facebook and Google and all those globalist creations are really, really clever. And they're really good at making sure I can't communicate with the outside world. I may be able to post things, but I don't know how many people are seeing it. Even on YouTube, I can't leave comments on anybody else's YouTube videos or anything because they won't let me. They censor my email so I don't receive messages from anyone. They are blocking my PayPal. They're doing everything. Everything they can to destroy my life. And a shadow government, every time I'm involved in anything in society with anyone, the shadow government is in there. And they talk to people behind my back. But I'll tell you that the stuff that's written all over my car, it opens up the door, another door where that they can't control. I have a lot of people that come and talk to me when they see my writings on my car. And they go on the internet and find out who I am. And a lot of people have taken pictures of my car. My car is like a celebrity car as far as social activists goes. I recommend that, you know, learn something, whatever it may be, about the evils of the world. Go out and get some dry erasable ink, you know, markers. And write something on your car. Every day, write something on your car. Go up to Tim Hortons or wherever your favorite hangout is and have people walk up and ask you, what's that written on your car? And talk to them. And then the next day, you can just wipe it all off and write a different message. And tell everybody, start using your vehicles as social media platforms. Start spreading the information and truth out to everyone. And I'll tell you, if everybody started using their vehicles as a means to get messages out to other people that don't know, we would take over this planet and clean up this mess very, very quickly. Okay? Turn your vehicle into a social media platform. And if your vehicle's too dark, go out and get those sticky magnetic things and get a white one and write on it. Dry erasable markers are great for that. My car, I've got paint on it. I've got an artist that were working on my car. I made mine permanent, most of it. Some of the ink fades, but I can retouch it up. So have a look at the links below this video and you'll see the link to my social media mobile platform, which is my car now. And you'll see other important links to other things. Thank you for listening. God be with you. And please do something to save this planet. It's not just about you and me and the women or anything else. It's the insane are killing this planet. And that CERN thing in Switzerland, that's really insane. There's no limit to their insanity. Unless you speak truth, you can't limit their insanity because they have full control. And what they do, because no one's stopping them. Bye.